I don't know about you, but some time ago I tried to break up with someone. I couldn't bear to hurt her there and then, so I decided to drag it out. One thing led to another, and now I'm married. The reason why I kicked off this video with the story is because LG has started rolling out the necessary firmware to enable 4K 120Hz Dolby Vision gaming for CX or C10 owners and also GX or G10 owners, starting in the company's native home country of South Korea. The global rollout will start from the middle of next week and be staggered through the end of October, so you may receive it next week and maybe the firmware will pop up on LG's website in your own country where you can actually download it to a USB drive and install it as such. But what about C9 owners then? Because LG is still continuing to tell journalists that they're still looking into the matter. And it falls to me, your friendly oriental YouTuber with a Mancunian accent, to explain the situation, to tell you why I genuinely think it is very unlikely that this 4K HDTV Dolby Vision gaming firmware will be enabled for the C9. And when I expressed my sentiment in my previous video when I talked about how the Xbox Series X has started enabling 4K HDTV Dolby Vision gaming in one of their software updates, some people said that my reasoning was wrong, that you know the chip on the C9 was perfectly capable of handling 4K HDTV Dolby Vision gaming. And reading through this forum post, it exactly illustrates my point as to why it is very unlikely for LG to develop the firmware to enable 4K 120Hz Dolby Vision gaming. You have to understand that fundamentally, the chip architecture of the C9 is different from the CX or C10 and also the C1. With the C1 and also the CX, there is a single chip that is HDMI 2.1 capable and it has an HDMI 2.1 bandwidth of 40 gigabits per second. So architecturally, the chipsets or the SoC on the CX and also the C1 are very similar, which is why you know it doesn't take LG that much effort to actually backport 4K 120Hz Dolby Vision gaming capability to the CX once the C1 has actually received it. But with the C9, the situation is quite different because at its core, the key SoC or the key chipset on the C9 is still an HDMI 2.0 chip. It is the O18 chip, which is actually the same chip as that found on 2018's C8 or E8. So what LG did to enable HDMI 2.1 on the C9 is to actually add an additional HDMI 6 chip, and this chip is actually responsible for taking in HDMI 2.1 signal even up to the full HDMI 2.1 bandwidth of 48 gigabits per second and then pre-process it so that it can be handled by this O18 HDMI 2.0 chip. So from the point of view of the hardware architecture, there is already a difference between the C9 and also the C10 and also the C1. Now, we do not know for sure that the C9 with its O18 chip plus an HDMI 6 chip can or cannot handle 4K 120Hz Dolby Vision for gaming purposes, especially in conjunction with the Xbox Series X. But what I do know is this: all companies, their resources are finite and you have to allocate them in a clever manner. So let's hypothetically say that you know there are 6 engineers on LG's team that works on firmwares. Now this is just a royalty-free image from Shutterstock. They are not actually Korean engineers, nor are they cast members of Squid Game attending the Emmys. But let's say there are 6 personnel and at any one point, the R&D team will be allocating certain personnel to deal with the current year model. So let's say that, you know, in 2021, it will be the C1. So 2 of them will be working on the C1. And 2 of them may actually be working on last year's model. That's the CX or C10. And you may think that the other 2, you know, the last 2 will be working on 2019 models. But that's far from the case at all, because those 2 will be working on next year's model, say 2022 models. And let's just say that, you know, there is a C2 OLED. They will be working on the C2 OLED. And usually by now, there will already be a pre-production sample, you know, for them to actually work on in the office, because, you know, they have to present these TVs at CES in January, which is actually not too far away. So if you can imagine that this is only a team for one line of TV, and then you have to talk about another line of TV with a different chipset, let's say the step down Alpha 7 chipset. So you can imagine that even a company as big as LG Electronics and also maybe Samsung Electronics and Sony, they have finite resources. You know, they don't actually have unlimited amount of personnel to expand on, you know, supporting more than 1 year old model. And I think that that is the reality of the situation. And obviously some of you may feel hard done, and some of you, you know, threaten that this will be the last LG that you will buy if the C9 doesn't actually get 4K 120Hz Dolby Vision. And that is cool, but I think the way people buy TVs, I think, you know, loyalty is overrated. I think, you know, it is just a figment of imagination. I think, you know, let's be honest here. You say that you will continue supporting LG if they enable 4K 120Hz Dolby Vision on the C9. But if Sony comes out with a super duper TV with all the HDMI 2.1 gaming features, you know, at a lower price than LG, will you jump ship? I think most people will, because, you know, at any one point in time, people usually make their purchase decision based on what's available at that time and what's best for them at the same price point compared to the competition. And throughout its lifetime, the C9 has received a number of firmware updates that improved its picture quality. Off the top of my head, I remember a firmware to enable HGIG that will disable tone mapping to be compatible with the HGIG function on the Xbox Series X, the Xbox One X, the PS4 Pro, and also the PS5. And that is one firmware. And there's another firmware that actually added 4K 120Hz VRR G-Sync capability to the C9 and also the E9. So from the point of view of firmware update support, I think LG has tried its best. And I'm not saying never, but I just want to lay out the situation to you straight, you know, without any sugarcoating, without any stringing you along. Because as Manchester United and Arsenal fans will know, it's the hope that kills. And all TV manufacturers, including LG Electronics, they are a corporation, they are a company, and not many people are as altruistic as I am, you know, giving out all this free advice and also all this technical testing for free on YouTube. You know, I could have been a full-time calibrator, I could have been a TV product manager, but here I am giving you advice and trying to explain how capitalism works. So, where were we with regards to the C9? Right, okay, I genuinely think because of the fundamental architectural difference between the chipset on the C9 and also the C10 and also the C1, I think it is unlikely that LG Electronics will expand the time to, you know, enable 4K 120Hz Dolby Vision gaming, because, you know, they have to write the code, they have to troubleshoot it, when they could be working on 2022 sets like the C2, which obviously, you know, will earn them more revenue and money to keep the company going and keep the shareholders happy. Who knows? Maybe LG will actually watch this video and say that, right, sod Vincent, you know, let's just prove him wrong. You know, he thinks he's a know-it-all. He thinks, you know, he has, you know, the lowdown on everything. You know, he's so smug, and let's prove him wrong. Let's enable 4K 120Hz Dolby Vision on the C9. In which case, I'm very happy. You know, I'm extremely happy to be wrong, because, you know, I have helped you guys, C9 owners, to get 4K 120Hz Dolby Vision gaming. So, you know, let's just see what happens, but I would advise you not to keep your hopes up. And you may claim that you have been missold the C9, that it is false advertising, that you can't actually get 4K 120Hz Dolby Vision gaming together. But let me ask you, when was the first, you know, time or instance when 4K 120Hz Dolby Vision gaming actually surfaced? I remember that it was only back in maybe what, March, April this year, when Xbox Series X released a beta software for the Alpha Ring, and then everyone suddenly realized that, wow, Dolby Vision 4K 120Hz was possible. And you have to remember that back in 2019, when HDMI 2.1 was just coming about on televisions, LG famously being the first, you know, to come out with an HDMI 2.1 television in the shape of the C9, they were actually just basing it off the specifications of the HDMI forum. They had really no source to test with, you know. The RTX 30 card wasn't out yet. The Xbox Series X wasn't out yet. The PS5s weren't out yet. So from that point of view, they were just basically basing it on HDMI 2.1 forum specifications. And, you know, I'm genuinely surprised that, you know, everything has worked out as well as it can. If you can just ask, let's say, Samsung Q90R owners who are still waiting for their ER update, X900H owners from Sony who are still waiting for full resolution 4K 100 meters, and I think that, you know, LG C9 owners generally had it quite good. And the question you LG C9 owners have to ask yourself is Dolby Vision gaming really that much better than HDR10 gaming? Find out the answer in my side-by-side comparison in this video here.